What's going on, good people? This video, we're going to do a behind the scenes video of the 2021 Christmas light show. There were some additions and changes to this year's light show from the previous year's show. So we're just going to cover everything. And if you want to see the video for 2020, you can go look at that. It's titled 2020 Christmas light show behind the scenes. All right, intro time. We are starting at the control box, and I know it looks like a mumbo jumbo mess, but it's not. It's really organized chaos. Coming in from the bottom, there's a black cord right here that comes in and goes to this outlet or these outlets. This one is actually a GFCI, if I can get under there. So that's the GFCI. This is the Raspberry Pi plug, and then there are some additional outlets. I have had an additional cord over here, but I took it out for my Tune2 sign because normally the Tune2 sign stays lit 24/7, but it kept tripping the GFCI, so I had to unplug it. And it was tripping the GFCI when it rained. So I just took it out altogether to quit having it cause problems with the entire show. But the power comes from here to these bus blocks. Then to fuses, that's what these black things are in the middle of the red wire. And then up to the relays. And then from the relays, they come over to each of the outlets that you see here. Now, as you see, each of the outlets are numbered, or the cords are numbered. That way I know where they go. The other end of the cord, I had an issue this year. I did not number them last year on the other ends. So I had to remap and figure out what went where. This year, I actually made a mapping table on my website, personal website that is, so that I know what goes where when it next year rolls around. All of the outlets are not being used. I did get an additional relay board compared from last year. I only had two relay boards, but this year I had three. So I was able to leverage more channels. And so this middle set of channels last year, or these middle set of outlets, were not being used. This year they are being used in a mismatched capacity. Next year, I hopefully will be able to utilize all of these. So up here, we have the Raspberry Pi. And somewhere in here is also, oh, there it is the FM transmitter with its corresponding blue wire as the antenna. This year, I use the FM transmitter plugged into a USB port. That way, it will work, send the data directly in via USB instead of using the audio out on the Raspberry Pi. There is, in my opinion, a difference when you use the USB audio out instead of when you use the audio jack on the Raspberry Pi to the FM transmitter audio jack. In Falcon Pi Player, there is when you do connect it via USB, it does show up as a USB device, and you are able to select that as an output. All right, so this is the Falcon Pi Player, and yes, I'm still running 4.6 in 2020. I did not upgrade like a lot of others did for 2021. I will be upgrading to the version 5 for the 2022 show. As you see here though, if you go into the settings and on the audio tab, you have the audio output device and you have the CD002, which is, as you see in parentheses, FM transmitter. It automatically names this device and is able to detect it accordingly when you plug it in via USB. If I disconnect this device, the setting will still be retained. However, it will show a message on the screen saying that the device could not be found and thus cannot send audio to it. All right, so that covers everything for the box. I did have some additional wires that I had to run in because I did have some additional props that I've added. So my show, for some people, they say they turned everything off, went during non-show hours. This Raspberry Pi runs 24/7. And what I have here, so I have this snowman here. Hello, snowman. So the snowman runs, and the snowman is plugged here, number 4. And as you see, the relay for number 4 is turned on at the moment. And so when the show is not running, the snowman is on. And the reason being is the snowman serves as this box is still functioning indicator when the show is not actively running. So anytime, you know, if I want to look out the show and don't necessarily want to log on to the computer, I can just look out the window or open the door, look out the door and see that the snowman is on. If the snowman is on, the show is running. All right, now that it is nighttime, I will show you off the additional props. We got candy canes. They're actually, the red ones are grouped in threes. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3. And then the two on the end are additional candy canes that I got from my parents. And so the white candy canes there, they actually had to be replaced. The bulbs in there was drawing too much current. So what I did was I took LEDs similar to these and stuffed them inside of those. The smaller candy canes already had enough lights in them, so I did not replace those as they did not draw too much current. One other thing that I did was to use the chicken wire, and I did this on the trees as well. So as you can see, there is right there chicken wire, and then the lights are attached to the chicken wire. And in this case with the tree, it is wound, the wire, the whole mesh is wound around the tree. And similar for these two windows down here at the bottom. This year we are using green floodlights. Last year I used red. These are the same lights. One of the lights did not make it as it got wet. So we're only down to two lights, and I will need to probably purchase some more for the future, but we are using green this year. I notice I have an issue with one of the bushes, and well, this bush rather. It has a shortener of some sort. We'll look at that in the off season. Also, we have additional lights added to the upper windows. Those are 200 each window. We have 300 on these. There's another 300 there. There's 300 in the white candy cane, and now the show is starting. The reds, another 300, and so forth. And then we also have some lights that are on the porch as well, as you can see, and the garage. And also, since the show is running, as you see, the snowman is turned off, or you can't really see the snowman turned off. But now you can see the snowman is turned off because the show is running. And the way I have configured this is that the snowman is only on when the show is idle. When the show is actually running, snowman goes off. So here you see lights switching on and off as usual. Down here by the road, which is not lit right now, is the Toon Toon sign. As I mentioned earlier, the Toon Toon sign is the same one from last year, but it's also the sign that has Christmas lights around the edge there that are shorting out for some reason. They didn't have that issue last year. So in the off season, I will take those lights off. I actually have a 120 volt LED strip. And so I'll probably be building a controller that will allow that LED strip to change colors and updating the sequences accordingly to be able to handle or to allow the lights to change colors with the rest of the show. That will wrap things up for this year's video. I'm showing you one of the sequences. I'm not sure which song this is. If you would like to see all of the sequences for the 2021 light show, you can go and check out the playlist for the 2021 light show. It's here on the YouTube channel. There are 8 songs in total. Any questions or comments, please feel free to drop those down below. I'll be sure to answer them as they come about. And thank you for watching.